In American education, in my own field of evolution, there's a very, very serious attempt to subvert science education. That doesn't seem to be happening in physics, or is it?
Oh, I don't think it's happening. I've never heard of anyone attacking the teaching of cosmology, but they don't go into it very much in high school. And at the college level, there's no attempt. I mean, you're not saying that at the university level, there's an attempt to subvert the teaching of evolution.
Well, I think so.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, I wasn't aware of that.
I've known teachers who, in almost every class they teach, there will be a significant minority, maybe even quite a large minority, of students who will ostentatiously fold their arms and kind of look defiant when you start talking about, maybe even walk out. In extreme cases, go and complain to the dean that they've been offended. Their religious beliefs have been offended.
One of the things that may work in this direction is that I think we over-rely on student evaluations.
Yes.
Student evaluations should not be given very great weight, partly for this reason, because they provide a incentive for the teacher to teach in an ingratiating, comfortable way.
Yes.
And I taught a course in the history of science. In fact, I will again in the fall. Mm-hmm. And I went a lot into the interaction of science and religion. And I was sort of hoping that some student would get upset with
yes.
me and that we would have an interesting interaction. But, you know, I'm at a position where I can live with it. I think for someone, say, an assistant professor who
yes.
doesn't have tenure,
yeah. yes.
it's a serious problem. It's not yeah. a serious problem for me. I was actually looking forward to a little Donnybrook. But it didn't happen. I don't think I
offended
anyone.
I wonder whether somebody of your clout and prestige might actually just look around and perhaps ask whether there are any junior professors of biology who are having a hard time.
Well, that would be interesting.
And perhaps you could put your weight behind them if they are getting in any trouble.
Yeah, well, the only people in the biology side here I know are senior professors.
Yes.
But, that's an interesting question, and I certainly will ask the question mm-hmm. if I have a chance. I had assumed that the universities, just as, you know, American secondary school education is pretty terrible on the average, American university education is pretty good, and when you get to graduate education, it's excellent. I assumed the same was true about academic freedom, that there's a lot of pressures at the high school level, much less so for undergraduates, and none at all for graduate students.
But I may be
wrong about that.
That may be. I have heard the story about Texas having a particularly disproportionate influence on textbooks.
Oh, yes. Well, that's just economics. That for historical reasons, Texas selects its textbooks at the high school level, excuse me, at the state level, and so it buys a lot of books all in one package.
Yes.
I remember I gave a talk once soon after coming to Texas to a convention of high school science teachers, and they were interested in just this sort of question, and I was talking about how it's important to resist pressures and teach evolution and all this sort of thing. And they sat there, they had heard that before. And then I said, I really didn't see why the question arose, because it seemed to me that every high school teacher should be able to select his or her own textbooks and to fit the kind of course that he or she wanted to give. At that point, I got a roar of applause and I got a standing ovation, because much more important to them then the question of what they taught is their intellectual independence. And they really chafed under the system of having prescribed courses with prescribed textbooks. Our daughter did not go to what we call a public high
yeah.
school. She went to the equivalent of an English public school.
A private school.
Yeah, Andover.
Yeah.
George Bush's old school, and although she turned out differently.
Yes, I'm glad to hear that.
And her professors, her teachers, they weren't called professors, her teachers designed their own courses, chose their own textbooks, and they were very much more stimulating courses.
I bet they were. Yeah.
There is this dirigiste tendency. People attack the idea of government doing things. They say government is inefficient, and then they do their best to make it inefficient by forcing it to behave in a bureaucratic, uniform way. Everyone has to use the same textbooks. I think people should be much more relaxed about people, even though they're employed by the government, doing things in the same kind of freewheeling way that you do in private business. And every once in a while, a taxpayer's dollar will be wasted. But I bet the taxpayer will get better value for their dollar that way than under the present system.
Thank you very much. It's been a great privilege.
Enjoyed it.
Thank you.